eLBOW is a tool for generating chemical restraints. It is a flexible and powerful tool that has many features. Its main purpose is to generate restraints for ligands and other non-standard chemical entities in a macromolecular model. The Phenix GUI has two eLBOW GUIs, both in the ligands button of the main menu. One is for the advanced user, but this tutorial is going to introduce the simplified wizard eLBOW GUI. Upon choosing the simple eLBOW GUI, the first panel displays some choices for molecular input of the ligand. Some are preferred because these formats generally provide unambiguous descriptions of the molecule topology. They include SMILES, MOL3D, or SDF, and the data from the chemical components library available from the PDB and distributed with Phenix. This is a database of SIF files that contains the chemical information for all of the chemical entities in the protein data bank. Formats at the bottom are not recommended because heuristics are needed to apply to determine the molecular topology, and there is room for error. It is always better to know enough about your ligand to use one of the preferred input rather than using that PDB input without connected records or hydrogens. Let's choose the chemical components input for this introduction. The next screen displays the options regarding the Cartesian geometry of the molecule. The simple option uses bond lengths calculated using quantum chemistry for ideal distances. The second option is a built-in RM1 AM1 semi-empirical QM method that is appropriate for most drug-like molecules. The next method uses a feature in eLBOW that can use third-party QM packages such as GAMES to generate high-level QM geometries. This requires additional setup. The final radio button option is to provide a Cartesian geometry from another file, such as a PDB file. This last option at the bottom is related to atom names. This allows a molecule to have the same atom names from another molecule of a similar topology. This is helpful when working with a series of similar molecules. Let's choose the AM1 option and OK. The file configuration screen has only those fields and buttons needed, as well as a few minor configuration options that are always shown. This button allows for searching of the chemical components library. Searching for water shows the water molecule as well as other water-containing entities. We only need to enter a residue code to generate restraints, so let's enter our toy example, HOH, which is the most common code for water. Clicking on Run will run eLBOW, which is very quick for water. The log file is displayed in this field and the output files in the Results tab. A successful job will result in a PDB file and a restraints file in SIF format. Either file can be useful in fitting the ligand into a model. Choosing the restraints file and then the real button will allow you to validate and edit the restraints, but that is for another tutorial. Thank you for listening.